Every software project needs a really good specification if it's going to succeed. But it takes a lot of practice to be able to write those specifications, and it's not easy. So today we're going to look at a very simple approach that anybody can use to write solid specifications and get their project done right. Hey everybody, I'm Dave Hecker, and today we're talking about how to write specifications for your outsourced software project. Let's first look at what the high-level objective is of the specification. All you really want to do is communicate what you need to the development team. Doesn't really matter how you do it or the format or what it looks like or how you deliver it. As long as you communicate it well, that's what we're going for. And it's not easy to do, but there is kind of a simple mentality that you can take that's going to help a lot. First, you want to keep in mind that you should always put in as much detail as possible. You can't have too much detail. Repeating yourself a few times or putting in some unnecessary detail wastes a little tiny bit of space on usually a virtual document. Forgetting something is a big expensive mess, so don't hold back. Try to get as much as you can. Also, imagine that the reader, your developer, is coming in with zero knowledge. Explain everything. No matter how rudimentary or obvious it seems, get it down on paper. Imagine they have nothing coming in. That's going to help a lot. And they have to learn everything from scratch. Use lots and lots and lots of words. Don't go short. Don't try to be concise. Really go for it and just keep typing or talking or whatever it is you do. So keeping those things in mind, we're going to walk through an example and I'm going to show you how easy it can be. This is sort of a brainstorming exercise. People think that when you write a requirement, you have to know exactly what's going on in your application. You've got everything in your head, and you're just writing it down. But it doesn't really work like that. Writing requirements is a brainstorming process. In this example, we're going to use a real example, which is a site that tracks people's weight loss. So when this client comes to the service provider, they say, I've got this great idea for the weight loss site, and here are the requirements. And let's say one of the requirements says something like this. Users can see metrics about their workouts. Sounds good. The client is probably thinking there's going to be all kinds of metrics. They can see how their workouts are going, how much weight they're losing, how much muscle they're getting, whatever it is. The developer, that doesn't really mean anything. They're going to say, well, what metrics are you talking about? I need more information. So already, we can just add words. That's the main part of the exercise, is just add stuff. Let's see if we can just add anything to that requirement. How about instead of user can see metrics about their workout, logged in user can see metrics about their workout. Not very useful, but we did add something, and it is true because the idea of the exercise is just to add stuff for brainstorming. So it's okay that it's not really meaty. Let's try it again. We can look at that and think, well, what kind of metrics are there? There could be lots of them. Let's try one. Logged in user can see a progress chart showing their weight loss. Now, this is getting good. Now we've got a specific metric in mind. We know that the user is logged in, and we're starting to develop a real requirement. Let's try to add one more thing. Logged in user can see the progress chart showing their weight loss, period. The chart will show the user's weight loss by day, week, or month. Now this is kind of getting interesting. Now at least we're drilling down on one feature. It's okay to repeat yourself, like we say, logged in every time. It seems obvious, right? But don't worry about that, because we want the developer to be crystal, crystal clear. We don't mind repeating our words. Okay, so we're brainstorming that way. Now we're going to brainstorm a totally different way. We're going to tell a user story. These are sometimes called use cases, sometimes called user stories, but it doesn't really matter. The idea is to get away from a requirement that says the user can do this and try something where it says this user enters the site and here's what they do, and it's sort of a narrative. So let's try the same requirement as a user story. Let's try it like this. A user wanted to see their weight loss, so they logged into the site and they viewed a chart showing their progress. That's kind of the same requirement, but it's just said in a different way. The reason that's so valuable is because now we're still brainstorming and we're going to think of a lot more stuff as we go. Let's try it again. We'll add a little more. We're brainstorming and we're adding stuff all the time. A user wanted to see their weight loss, so they logged into the site, clicked on My Progress, and saw a chart showing their weight loss. This is even better. Now we came up with something new. The developer didn't know that there's an area called My Progress. So just through this brainstorming process, we started to build out the navigation, and it's getting more and more useful to the developer. Let's try it again. A user wanted to see their weight loss, so they logged into the site, clicked on my progress and saw a chart showing their weight loss. Their weight had gone up that week, and because they were gaining weight, the chart was displayed in red. Now that might be something you just thought of while you were brainstorming that use case, but it doesn't matter. If you want to capture it down, if it's something you want built, write it down. You don't need to go from beginning to end and write down every single piece of the application in one go. It never works like that. Consider it a brainstorming exercise and just jump around all over the place. And when something comes to you, just add it in and just start typing and typing and typing. And you'll drill down on each requirement just like we did on that one. After you add to one requirement, go back to the use case and read that. And then go back and forth. And if you think of something else, jump to another requirement. It doesn't matter. Just alternate, keep moving. So to sum it up, you want to alternate between requirements and user stories. You want to be brainstorming. You want to keep adding stuff. You can never have too many words. Repeating yourself is okay. And imagine that the reader of the document is starting with zero knowledge. They're coming in totally cold. So that's it for today. For more outsourcing advice, be sure to visit us at SourceSeek.com. And be sure to subscribe to our channel for weekly tips. We also want to hear from you, so please leave your comments and questions below. We're going to answer every comment and question that comes in. We'll see you soon.